AI is not a brand new field of technology. In fact, AI is almost 70 years old. AI, the term of AI was conceived in the 50s. Alan Turing, one of the pioneers of computer science and AI, proposed, for example, a Turing test that we continue using today in the 1950s. The term itself, artificial intelligence, was in fact conceived in 1956. Some other important breakthrough happened since that time. In 1957, the perceptron, which is the first emulation of a neural network, a neural, in fact, was conceived in 57. The first chatbot, Eliza, was in 1965. As you can see, this is things that now is very common to talk about chatbots, but the first one was from 65. The first expert system was in 1965 too. And lots of hype at that time were about what is and the use of artificial intelligence. But unfortunately, during the 70s, we reached the first AI winter. Was a period of time where no investments were made more in artificial intelligence, in AI. Because there was a disillusion about what is the value that you can get with AI. A second winter happened in the 87 to 93. Another period that no one would really like to talk about AI. Until 1997, when IBM launched the Deep Blue. This big machine with some of AI technology on it win the chess championship of that time. Garry Kasparov. This was a breakthrough in terms of the AI timeline. And after that, with the advent and the explosion of internet and all of this new data coming, another breakthrough happened in the beginning of the 2000s. In 2009, a group from Stanford built the ImageNet, a very important data set with images that we are used to train some very important features that we have today using AI, like face recognition, like to how you can recognize a face using this kind of image. In 2011, IBM launched IBM Watson. IBM Watson was another breakthrough because Watson was presented to the world during a challenge in the Jeopardy game and won against two important competitors, two ex-champions. The same year, 2011, we were presented to Siri. Hi Siri.
Hello Alexandra Dietrich. How's it going?
When the lockdown will end.
Here's what I found.
Well, this was a very breakthrough, and we start to have this kind of directly conversation with intelligent systems that can understand our spoken language. Another breakthrough was Alexa in 2014. Alexa, what's the weather like right now in Toronto?
In Toronto, Canada, it's 5 degrees Celsius with partly sunny skies.
Well, another breakthrough from Amazon, Alexa. In 2016, we have another breakthrough with AlphaGo from Google. AlphaGo win the Go champion in a very, very tough board game. Was another breakthrough with lots of use of reinforcement learning and deep learning. In 2018, Google launched again a new breakthrough, BERT. It's a kind of model that we use to improve the natural language processing. The same happened in the last year with OpenAI GPT-2. Another breakthrough in the natural language processing. As you see, many, many different breakthroughs during more than 60, 70 years. But lots of different companies are using AI in different ways, are using some parts in machine learning to build some recommendation systems. We have seen lots of things happen in the last years around machine learning and artificial intelligence.